Good afternoon and welcome to Balmoral for the Belfast Championship Dog Show. In the next 50 minutes or so, we'll be finding out what goes on at a big dog show like this. There are some 3,000 entries this year. We'll first of all start off with the obedience classes, which are taking place in these rings here just behind me. Then later on, we'll move indoors to the Alexander Hall for the best in groups and the best in show. And of course, this is the championship show in Northern Ireland from which the winners qualify to go on to the All Hallowed Crufts. Mike Edgar's here along with me today, and he'll be out and about with our roving camera, finding out what goes on behind the scenes. And believe me, there are quite some scenes behind them. But first of all, this afternoon, let's start off with the obedience classes. Well, now we see Michael McCartney from Dunmurry with his dog, Well Done Glen Boy. And he's just psyching the dog up, I suppose, giving it instructions for the part of the test that's called the send away. And what happens here is that the dog has to be sent where the handler tells it to go. And in this case, it's to a mat which is at the far side of the ring. Now, Well Done Glen Boy is just heading straight for it now, in between those yellow markers which you can see coming up now. Now, Well Done Glen Boy has not actually lain down where he should have. He should be lying on that orange mat between the two yellow markers. Well Done Glen Boy is one of the few Northern Ireland dogs, in fact, taking part in the obedience class. Quite a number of the dogs today, of course, will have come over from across the water, as indeed have quite a number of the judges, including Mrs. Sheriff, who's judging this class for us today. Dogs here from the Isle of Man, from England, Scotland, from down as far as County Meath, from all over the place, in fact, who are coming to just have a chance that they might be able to score enough points today to be the winner and to go on to Crufts.
Yep, turn. Halt. Test finished.
And this time we see Stanley Moreland from Lisburn putting his dog Xandos Jupiter, better known to him as Bobby, through his paces in the heel work. And you can hear the judge's steward shouting the instructions. He has to walk straight past this time, turn about then, and pick the dog up on the way past. And Paula Sharif, who is the judge in this instance, is looking for accuracy. She's looking for a liveliness from the dog and for a good control between the dog and the handler. But as she told me earlier, she doesn't want to see a dog which impedes the handler. She wants to see a dog and a handler who work with
fear movement and work well together.
Time!
Do no doubt.
Yep, turn. Normal pace.
Well, the dog we're looking at now is an obedience Irish champion this time. Sealight Hearty of Zellmark, splendid name indeed. And has travelled up here today along with its owner, Cathy Gillert from Dublin. Test now over, and she gives him a little pat. Now, Sealight Jeremy, this time a local dog from Newton Ards, being handled by its owner, Mrs. McCartney. And Sealight Jeremy is a 9-year-old dog, so it'll be interesting to see a dog with a fair bit of experience goes almost straight to the little packet of money and brings it straight back to Mrs. McCartney. Test has to be properly completed dog has to sit until he's told that he can relax again, and he gets a little bit of a pat from Mrs. McCartney. This dog is Ivo's cross purposes. It's owned by Mrs. Watson, that's Herbie Watson's wife. They've come over from Darlington in County Durham with three of their dogs, in fact four of their dogs today. And at the moment Mrs. Watson is getting Ivo's cross purposes to look straight at the target at the far side of the ring, the orange mat between the two yellow markers. She gives the instruction and the dog heads almost straight to the target, very close to it this time.
Yes, indeed.
Now we can see Mrs. Sharef bringing the rags out of the bag, which she is going to put her own scent on.
Well, it's so cold, you're not going to get any scent on them, are you, otherwise?
Now, this is the best part of the show. Now, Mrs. Watson this time giving the scent to the dog, Evo's cross purposes, and this dog is actually in the lead at the moment in Class C in the obedience. He's done very well indeed up to now, losing only 6.5 points. He's getting a good scent off that piece of material, and she then sends him off along the line. Ooh. And of course it's that fourth rag up, that he's just picked it up now, in fact, and has brought the right rag back to his owner. So that should stand Evo's cross purposes in very good stead. 50 points for this part of the competition. He was in the lead before the scent tests, and that should mean that, in fact, he has won and is the obedience champion here today.
Paula Sharef, what do you think of the standard of the class today?
Well, I was very pleased with it on the whole, given the fact that it's an interesting venue with lots of things happening and fairly blustery at the moment. I think both dogs and competitors did very well.
What is the most difficult part of the obedience test, do you think?
Well, it's difficult to say because some dogs have more difficulty with some exercises than others. I think the main problem today for the majority of competitors was the send away. Although, from where I was standing, it looked comparatively easy, or at least not too difficult. Some of the dogs were still attracted either to one side or the other and didn't go quite straight.
We were very impressed with the way that you warmed up the little pieces of rag for the scent test. Is that something you normally do?
Yes, it is. The scent test is a difficult enough test as it is without making it more difficult. So I always put the cloths inside my clothes, for want of a better expression, so that they're always warm and they're always covered in my scent, even before I take them out and actually rub the scent from my hands on them.
Right. Well, now, Jenny Watson, your dog had no trouble at all with that test, with the scent test, and in fact did so well that he won the class today.
Yes.
Had you won here at Belfast before?
No, I've never. I think this is our 11th trip over, and it's the first time I've ever won over here.
Mm. You had four dogs, I think, in the obedience today, is that right?
Yes, we did, yes.
And how did the rest of them do?
Well, my daughter won the bitch championship, so that was lovely. Mm-hmm. And my husband came reserve to me with his young dog.
Does it take a lot of work to get your dogs to that standard?
Yes.
I'm sure it does. What sort of hours are we talking about putting in?
Well, we train every day, at least for an hour, every single day, to try and keep them at the level they are.
Well, now we'll take a break and go and see what Mike Edgar's been finding out and about.
Well, here I am, first thing in the morning at the dog show. All these cages have yet to fill up. When they asked me to do it, they didn't say I had to start at 7 o'clock in the morning. However, I wasn't the first one here. There's a few colourful characters yet to be met. Let's go and see them. Well, now, Jim, from the hat and the various bits and pieces, I can tell you're not from this part of the world.
That's right. I'm Richard from Hollywood, California.
And it's a long way to come for the Belfast Dog Show.
Yes, that's so. But I'm now living in Scotland and breeding dogs for the last year and a half over there, so we've been here before.
Well, when did you, and this is a Pekingese dog, when did you start breeding Pekingeses?
Over 40 years ago.
It's a long, long time.
That's
in,
right.
In America, I take it?
In America, yes.
Now, is it very different showing dogs over in America than it is here?
Yes, quite different. If you're really going to show dogs and try to go someplace with them, you use a professional handler.
I would imagine the situation here is quite different. If we were having a dog show here in Ireland, you can get to anywhere really within a day. But in America, you're traveling thousands of miles. Very expensive.
That's right. That's why you have a handler, so he can travel to these shows.
How did you get into starting breeding the dogs in the first place?
Well, I think it helps if you're a little bit crazy, but I think if we get into any animals or any other hobby that you start as youngsters and you love animals or you want to just can't stand them.
Could you not have had yourself a wee bit of a job training the animals for the movies in Hollywood or whatever?
Yes, I did. I was working in the movies back in the 40s and then continued on with my own set decorating company.
You weren't responsible for Roy Rogers and Trigger and all that, were you?
No, I wasn't, but I did train a lot of horses with him.
Now, romance is in the air. We'll come to that in 2 seconds. Yeah. Tell us a little bit about this dog and its history.
Well, this is a young Pekingese bitch, 11 months old, is now just about finished with her junior warrant.
So, have you got high hopes for today?
Yes, we do. Of course, we don't know what the judge is going to say.
Well, hang about. We'll see about that in a minute.
Okay, sure.
As I said, romance is in the air. Dan, can you tell me how you and Jim first got together?
That would be about 1980. He came down with friends of his from Glasgow area to visit, as he had previously bought a dog in America and had a son belonging to him and puppies off him. So he came down to have a look at the pups and see what he thought of them.
So dog loving can bring people together?
Yes.
How did he get round to popping the question, if you don't mind me asking?
Well, he hasn't quite got round to that.
That's coming.
That's
in the offing,
yes,
at the moment. You also have a claim to fame about your Irish ancestry. Tell us about that.
Well, my father told me one time his grandfather was one of the first people to be run down by the motor car. And I think the speed limit then was about 6 miles an hour.
Must have been lying on the road or something along those lines.
Well, maybe I'd won too many.
Well, what have we got here?
West Highland
Terriers
and Snyder.
Let's see one of these dogs out. Got their own wee trolley and all.
Yeah.
Isn't that amazing? Isn't he? Is it a he or a she?
A he.
I'm glad I said that first time round. Have you been painting these dogs?
No.
What's all that white stuff that's coming off?
That's chalk.
Well, why the chalk? What's the chalk for?
Well, I have to get them clean for showing, and it's just how everybody's always done it.
Surely when the judge comes up and runs his hand down the back of this beautiful dog, it's going to get a white hand, he's going to know you're up to no good.
Oh, pop it all out before they come in.
Skullduggery in the doggy business.
Yeah.
Where have you come from?
Oma.
And you trundle them around this wee trolley?
Yeah.
Good luck to you today.
Thanks.
Well, now, here's a woman with a very strange dog indeed. Would you like to tell me what you've got here?
Yes, I have an Affenpinscher. These are of German origin. They're known as monkey terriers. Their face is like a monkey. They were known as ratters in the stables of the castles in Germany.
And does this mean she's a vicious wee thing?
She could be, I think.
What would happen if I went over to stroke her there?
Quite
her a wee
all
kiss?
Right.
Would it be all right?
Yes.
Are you now sure about this?
Yes, quite
give
sure.
Hello, darling. Hello.
She's called Mabel.
Mabel? Yes. And she's very, very rare.
Yeah, there are. She's the only one in Northern Ireland.
Isn't she?
No, actually, she's not the only one in Northern Ireland. Because I have 7 of them.
And is she worth lots and lots of money?
I wouldn't put a price on her.
You would never take any money for her?
No, I'm deeply superstitious.
Oh, look at that. You're looking like... Oh, you like that, don't you? Don't you like that? Well, look at this, folks. I've made a friend. This is, in fact, Daring, and Daring's owner, Stuart. Stuart, you've come a long way.
Yeah, yes. We've come over from Lincolnshire. Regularly coming over to Belfast and Southern Irish shows.
And is this Daring's first trip over?
No. Daring's been over about 32 times.
With any success?
Yes, Daring is the first homebred Irish champion.
Isn't that marvellous? Now, what sort of a dog is Daring? I mean, is he a working dog?
Yes, he is. They're Bouvier de Flanders.
I'm glad you said that, not me.
Originally, they were cattle dogs. Now, they're usually used as police dogs.
Police dogs? A hairy mutt like this is a police
yes.
dog? You usually see Alsatians.
Yes. Now, in Europe, they're very, very popular, very easy to train. And very, very hardy.
Well, when a dog like Daring wins a big competition like this, does this mean that you come into lots and lots of money?
No.
Is it just simply for the prestige?
Simply for the prestige.
Now, Mr. Harry Jordan, who's judging the Terrier Group, just taking a walk up and down the line and having a look at the dogs before he calls them out individually to assess them. This is the Airedale, Mrs. Gregg of Carrie Duff's Bambusa Montagne. And the Airedale is known as the king of the terriers. The breed originated about 100 years ago in Yorkshire, and it's thought to be a combination of the English Terrier and the Otter Hound. And during the First World War, these dogs were used extensively as army dogs and also for police work. Very affectionate dog, full of intelligence, and very smart looking too when it's as well trimmed as Bambusa Montague is today. Mrs. Gregg from Carrie Duff showing her dog off well. Now the Bull Terrier, Kenmare's Caliph, owned by Mr. and Mrs. Smith of Carrickfergus, a 3-year-old Bull Terrier bitch. And this is known as the gladiator of the canine race. Now number 917, Sheolin Tartan Fair. Little Scottish Terrier this time. But this one doesn't come from Scotland, it comes from Ballymena, in fact. It's owned by Mr. Rioch from Galgorm Drive there. A 3-year-old dog. Lovely coat, black and shiny. And up to the middle of the 19th century, all dogs in Scotland that would have been used to go to ground after foxes were known as Scottish Terriers. This little one's a sturdy, thick-set dog of a good size to go to ground, and a very keen working terrier. Now one of the most popular of the terrier breeds, in fact. Mr. Jordan just having another little look at this Scottish Terrier. Now on the table for Mr. Jordan to look at is Townville Terry, a little fox terrier wire-haired bitch, which is owned by Mr. Sharp from Nottinghamshire. Mr. Jordan bouncing it up and down a little bit there, making sure that the little wire-haired terrier has the sort of muscular and bone structure that he wants to see. Mr. Sharp carries Townville Terry onto the ground and takes him in that triangular walk which the judges like to see. You can see whenever this little terrier walks, he almost kicks his legs up in front of him as he goes along, only just touching the ground. A very alert terrier with a nice keen expression and on the tiptoe of expectation all the time. Mr. Kelly with Brookfield Lady. Now we have a very nice little Irish Terrier, number 734, Ben's Air Rambo, owned by Harry Davis from Newton Arts, who had 5 dogs entered today, in fact. This is a little 2-year-old dog. Very nice little Irish Terrier. They have great temperament and quite a reckless air about them, too. Great sportsmen, and they fear absolutely nothing. They're known as the Red Devil, in fact, quite often, and they're very devoted to their masters. Mr. Jordan looking for a nice long head with a flat skull. He wants to see eyes which are full of life and dark in colour. Just throwing an object away there so that the little Irish Terrier can follow it over. And the little wire-haired fox terrier, Townville Terry, is the best in the terrier group. Well, Mr. Jordan is judging the utility group as well, and this is the Dalmatian he's looking at this time, number 962, Clydevale Vital Spark, owned by Mr. Hamilton from Glasgow. Not 101 of these Dalmatians here today, but there have been quite a number of them, and they're lovely dogs. Strong, muscular, active dogs of good temperament. And the ground colour should be pure white. The black spotted dog should have dense black spots, not running together. Now, this is the miniature poodle, Champion Navarre's Executive, owned by Mrs. E. Holmes of Leeds. Just not too happy about running on up the side again for her. Mr. Jordan waiting patiently Well, this little miniature poodle digs his heels in well and truly. I think possibly the little dog's a bit scared because earlier on this afternoon part of the white fence fell down at the side and I think that it gave him quite a fright, so he doesn't want to walk past it again. His handler is always very aware of that, but dragging him up for another look from the judge anyway. That's a little miniature poodle, Champion Navarre's Executive. And this is its friend, the Tibetan Terrier. It's not really a true terrier. It's never been used to go to ground. This particular one goes by the splendid name of Araki Frisia Assets. It's a champion and comes from Worcestershire. Its owner, Mr. Drysdale. These were also bred for centuries in the monasteries of Tibet. Well-muscled, sort of medium-sized dog. Not unlike a shrunken old English sheepdog, in fact, although this particular one of quite a darker colour. Sort of smoke grey and black. Araki Frisia Assets, the best Tibetan terrier in Belfast Championship Dog Show today. Now this is a Lhasa Apso, Metawand Tuvaruan, number 1149. It's owned by Mrs. Mathers from Bangor. Lhasa Apsos also come from Tibet, where they were used as guard dogs. In fact, in its own native language, it would be known as a bark lion sentinel dog. They have charming manners and have many devotees. Now, this is a Dutch barge dog, which Mr. Jordan's having a look at the moment. A Keys Hunt, number 1143. Irish champion, Demoniac Effendi. Brought all the way up from County Wicklow today by a lady with a very well-known name, Mrs. E. Wogan. It's the Dutch national breed. And Mr. Jordan has one final look before he decides on the winner and the reserve. Decision obviously between these two dogs, the Tibetan Terrier and the Dalmatian. And it's the Dalmatian which has won the utility class Clydevale Vital Spark from Glasgow. Champion Clydevale Vital Spark and the reserve best in the utility group is the little Tibetan Terrier. Champion Araki Frisia Assets from Worcestershire. Now, the toy class once more being judged by Harry Jordan, and this time we have the little Cavalier King Charles, Irish champion Sorata Raffles Araf, owned by Miss Ryan from Dublin. And over the years, the faces of these little spaniels has grown shorter and shorter, but they're very popular little dogs now. This now is a long-haired Chihuahua with a very splendid name, Yosinga Spellbinder, champion Yosinga Spellbinder, owned by the Leonards from Wimbledon. Tiny little dog, as you can see. Thought to be the smallest dogs in the world, the Chihuahuas. They're of Mexican origin, descended from the sacred dog of the Aztecs. And then they were developed to what they are today in the United States. Now a little Japanese chin, Mundeer's Shinshi, owned by Mr. and Mrs. Gregg of Monkstown. It's a breed that first came to England about 120 years ago. Very old breed. And quite a number of these dogs would have been seen in the decorations on old Chinese temples. Very decorative, dainty in appearance, with a small, compact carriage and a nice coat. Now Mr. Jordan's having a look at a little Papillon Black Park Cameo. A champion owned by Mr. and Mrs. Urquhart from Dunfermline in Scotland. Papillon, the French for butterfly. And you can see from this little dog's ears just why it's named by that. The ears must either be completely erect or dropped. Very dainty, balanced little dog with an attractive head and a lively expression. This little King Charles Spaniel was the winner of the Any Variety Not Classified part of the toy dogs. Little King Charles. Something's definitely distracting this little dog as it goes round the ring today. It's owned by Mr. R. Murta of Ravenhill Park here in Belfast and has the grand name of Winter Affair by a Mantra. And that completes Mr. Jordan's look at the toy class. He's now going to call out some of the dogs from which he will then pick his winner. And he's called out the Papillon and the Pug. Having one final look at them before he decides which will be the winner of the best in group. In the toy group. Decision time now, and Mr. Jordan is going to give the best in group rosette to the Papillon. And that's Champion Black Park Cameo number 2074, owned by Mr. and Mrs. Urquhart from Dunfermline, who will no doubt think that they had a very worthwhile journey today. Well, now we'll take a break and go and see what Mike Edgar's been finding out and about around Balmoral this afternoon.
Now, we're in the puppy bitch class, and this is one of the top winning dogs of all the shows of this year. Tell us a wee bit about her, Eleanor.
Top winning, one of the top winning puppies in Beagles. Make it correct.
Right.
She's smooth coated breed, she's a Beagle bitch, and she's from Champion Parentage.
Isn't she gorgeous? How many shows has she won this year?
She's won at 9 championship shows this year and had best puppy at 6 of them.
And that means she's straight through to Crufts, no problem?
She's qualified for Crufts 9 times over.
Goldust, you're Goldust. Give us a kiss. Oh, I love it. Oh. Well, no, here's a dog and a half. What's this particular dog's name?
Penny.
Penny, and what age is she?
Just two.
And breed?
Pyrenean Mountain Dog.
Now, how's she been doing in the championships so far?
Well, she won last week at Darlington.
And any other championships before that?
Just that seconds and thirds and limit to qualify after life for Brooks the way it is at the minute.
That is beautiful. Is it hard work looking after a colt like this?
Depends on the weather.
How you doing, Daphne? I can see the red eyes. I know, I've had the same problem, a couple of drinks too many. What? You're not enjoying the show? You're a wee bit cold. Dear, love you. Listen, good luck on the show. Okay, Daphne? Take care of yourself. Watch those eyes. Well, now, this is Tara. What age is Tara, Joan?
6 months.
And what class does that put her in?
Minor puppy bitch.
What age group do minor puppies come into then?
6 to 9 months.
6 to 9 months old. How hopeful are you that she's going to get something today?
I don't know.
Is she nervous?
Yes, about being benched.
This is her first show. Time,
the very first show, so she is nervous.
It's a hard time for a wee dog like you, isn't it? Good luck with you anyway, Joan.
Thank you very much.
Well, Margaret, you've come all the way from Liverpool. What class will Slim be entering in?
Slim's a British champion, and she'll be in the champion stakes today.
British champion? So
yep.
What does it take to be a champion dog?
To be a champion dog, you've got to win 3 challenge certificates, which is you've got to have best of breed at 3 championship shows.
Slim won more than 3, or...?
Yeah, she was the top bitch last year. She's got 5 CCs and 2 reserve CCs.
Do you breed your own bulldogs?
Yes, I do.
Are they difficult to breed?
No, not difficult to breed. Bulldogs get a lot of bad press. Usually that's indiscriminate breeding. The interested breeders, the reputable breeders, don't have no problems.
So as far as you're concerned, really, they're a good family dog?
Yes, I think so. Lovely family dog, good guard dog, love children. Obviously, you can't take these on 10-mile hikes. If you enjoy walking, you go for a different breed. But they're a fantastic dog, and it upsets me, the bad press they do get. Totally unfounded.
Well, now, are these collies hard to look after?
Not really, no. Not when you do them every week.
What class will you be entering her in?
Open bitch.
How's her form been this season?
Super. We've been winning at most championship shows, and we took CC and best of breed at Birmingham 3 weeks ago.
That's marvellous. Does she come from a good line?
I think so, yeah.
Did you breed her herself?
No, my mother bred her, but we bred on from her.
Do you have many at the moment?
Yes, we have 11 plus litter puppies.
Which is certainly more than a handful.
Certainly is, yes.
Good luck to you.
Thank you very much.
Now we move to the hound group, and the judge for this group is a very well-known English judge, Mrs. Joan Wells Meacham from Buckinghamshire. Very lugubrious-looking individual, this one. Champion Lodway Lancer of Isleworth. It's owned by Mr. and Mrs. Roberts from Newport in Gwent. Very compact, short-legged hound with long pendulous ears and quite a sad expression too. And the skin on their head is supposed to be loose so that it wrinkles noticeably when it's drawn forward, and the rest of the skin is supposed to be quite loose as well, in fact. Mrs. Roberts putting champion Lodway Lancer of Isleworth through his paces. Now, this is a Borzoi hound. Takavonov Alexandrov. Very regal name for an extremely regal-looking dog. This is a local dog from Bangor in County Down, being shown by its owner, Mr. Agnew. They've been used in Russia since the 17th century, the Borzois, for hunting wolves and for coursing hare and other game. Large, handsome, elegant dogs. As you can see, they have quite a deal of muscle hidden under that long coat, and great speed with those big long legs. The back rises in a graceful arch. They have a long, graceful muzzle as well. Russian breed Borzoi. Well, now from the height and strength of the Borzoi, right down to the ground, to Shenelig Susanna of Ardlochan. This little miniature long-haired dachshund hails from Berra in County Tyrone. From a very small Irish dog to an extremely large one. This time it is champion Hydebeck Reginald Snuffson, and for any of you who were watching Belfast Championship Dog Show last year, you would instantly recognise this as the supreme champion of the show last year. Owned by Mr. and Mrs. Noel of Bridlington. After the extinction of wolves, then the breed almost disappeared, but it was rescued in 1885 by a Captain Graham, who founded the Irish Wolfhound Club. Now, this delightfully elegant dog is a Saluki, one of the oldest known breeds of domesticated dogs. Its history can be traced right back to 329 BC. This particular one comes from Newtownards, Mumtaz Savannah of Peblu. And the whole appearance of the breed gives an impression of grace and symmetry, a very dignified expression and bearing. Now, this little smooth-haired dachshund also hails from Newtownards. In fact, it's owned by Mrs. Cunningham, and it's Irish champion Fablehaft Firefly. The dachshund's coat should be short, dense and smooth. Mrs. Wells Meacham just making sure that the dog has the right sort of bone structure and muscular structure. Checking his face. Nice gentle looking dog this time. Mrs. Cunningham putting her smooth-haired dachshund through her paces. Mrs. Wells Meacham casting a very experienced eye there, making sure that she moves just as she would wish her. The long-haired dachshund, owned by Miss M. Sloan from Lisburn, Hampdack Huntsman of Fablehaft. The long-haired version was produced by crossing the old long-coated spaniel with a dachshund. The coat should reach its greatest length on the tail, where it forms a sort of flag, and indeed you can see that that is the case with Hampdack Huntsman of Fablehaft. Now Mrs. Wells Meacham takes a walk down the line. Here's another look at the hounds, who have already, of course, won their best in breed to have made it as far as the best in group here today at Belfast Championship Dog Show. And the Basset Hound. Is the winner in this group, in the hound dogs, with last year's show champion, Hydebeck Reginald Snuffson, in the reserve. So the Basset Hound, champion Lodway Lancer of Islwyn from Newport in Gwent, is the best in the hound group today at Belfast Championship Show. Now, the first of the gun dogs is on the table, an American Cocker Spaniel, Avon Rose Country Made, being handled by a very young lady indeed, who I think must be a Miss Hanlon from Sandyford in County Dublin, and if I'm right, her mother is the owner of this dog, Avon Rose Country Made Arif. Now being put through her paces, a lovely little American Cocker Spaniel, Avon Rose Country Made Arif. The English Springer Spaniel, however, is a different kettle of fish altogether. It's the oldest of the British sporting gun dogs. And this particular one goes by the name of White Heather. And it's owned by Mr. Hare from Finnehy in Belfast. And Mrs. Wells Meacham will be looking for a symmetrical, compact dog. They're built for endurance and activity. The coat should be close, straight, and most important of all, because of the work which the English Springer Spaniel has to do, it needs to be weather resistant as well. Now this gun dog is a Vimeraner Tri-Light Enforcer owned by Mr. McGuinness of Woodvale Road in Belfast. Originally it was a big game dog, which seems to have come from the same stock that produced some of Germany's hunting breeds, bloodhounds and pointers. Now, Mrs. Wells Meacham looking at Stormridge Midnight, a German short-haired pointer. She's looking for the sort of overall confirmation of the dog that everything should be balanced well. This time a Belfast dog owned by McKelvey's in Belfast, Bethrop Golden Lass of Greenbrook. And this dog's a particularly good colour for the breed. Examining his ears. And the shoulder placement of the dog as well, very important in a golden retriever. The tail. She wants to see that the tail reaches the correct point on the dog's leg as well. And she makes her final decision from those five dogs. And she's given the best gun dog to the German short-haired pointer, champion Stormridge Midnight from Nottinghamshire. And the reserve in the gun dog class goes to the little American Cocker Spaniel, Avonrose Country Made Arif from Sandyford in Dublin. Well, now the last of the groups today, this time the working group. Now, this is number 1841, a Bernese, Forgeman Footsteps, owned by Mr. and Mrs. Cooper in Garva. Very attractive dog. And again, the judge is looking for the correct conformation in the dog. Now we have a Doberman. Champion Salates Ferris. Owned by Mr. and Mrs. Bevan from Brighton. It's being handled this time by Mr. Anderson. The Doberman should have a good long neck and a nice elegant head. A Newfoundland this time from County Mayo, owned by Mrs. A. Kearney. Little Creek Vaguely Noble. A sturdily built dog this time with a long coat. Once more a big breed. It loves the water, in fact. Now the Samoyed, Santa's Boy, owned by Mr. R. Bickerstaff from Bangor in County Down. And the Samoyed should have a fully white coat with just the black pigmentation. The black pigmentation around the eyes and nose of this all-white dog, particularly important. And Mr. James chooses his best in the working dog group, and it's the Doberman. Delighted owner, Mr. Anderson from Brighton, handling the dog for Mr. and Mrs. Bevan, and the reserve is the Old English Sheepdog. Now, as the tension mounts towards the best in show, no doubt our Mike has been able to find something else for us.
Well, Eileen, you got your hands full here. Is this a family?
This is a family. They're all related.
And what about the breeding?
The breeding, this one here, her father was the well-known champion canvas, Capus Christopher. Her father is the champion Nortonwood Fawless.
Lovely.
And she comes from the Wesley line. So they're all well-known working and show dogs.
So what classes will you be entering them in?
I'll be entering in postgraduate, limit and open.
Wonderful. Well, good luck to you, Eileen.
Thank you very much.
Do they take you for a walk or do you take them?
They take me.
Goodbye.
Thank you very much.
And now to the moment that everyone's been waiting for this afternoon, to the best in show. And the first dog that Mrs. Wells Meacham is looking at this afternoon is the little wire-haired fox terrier, number 718. Townville Terry, Mr. Sharp from Nottingham's little bitch. Very, very bright, alert-looking little dog. She's moved on now to the Doberman. Salatis Ferris, number 1443. Dog in beautiful condition, tremendous sheen off the coat. All of these dogs have already won the best in the breed and also the best in their group this afternoon. It's entirely up to Joan Wells Meacham to decide now which one of these very splendid dogs should be the best in the show. And she seems to be heading for that lovely Doberman. So the Doberman Salatis Ferris from Brighton, owned by Mr. and Mrs. Bevan and handled today by Mr. Anderson, is the best in show at Belfast Championship Dog Show. And the reserve champion was the Basset Hound, champion Lodway Lancer of Islwyn, owned by